from learnguitarinlondon.com, and I'm playing kind of my own version and Thin Lizzy's version of Whiskey in the Jar. I mean, it's a traditional Irish song anyway, so when things are traditional, they just get passed down and down and down, so there's always going to be different people's interpretation of it. And I just really, really like this song. It's brilliant if you're a beginner, especially this version, because there's just a few open chords that you need to know and one go-to strumming pattern that you could use pretty much from a lot of songs. So I'm going to be teaching you that pattern. There is a little lead guitar solo in it, which I was kind of singing at the end there with that. So if you want to get that solo, then stay tuned for the end of this video. So what we're going to do is we're going to get started straight away and just have a look at the left hand here and check out the rhythm pattern. Okay. So the beginning of this starts with a G power chord. Okay, so we're index finger on the first fret on the third string and ring finger on the fifth fret on the A string. Okay, I could talk in a minute. So this is the E string. Eddie 8 Dynamite Goodbye Eddie is how I label the string. So third fret and fifth fret here. Okay, what you can do also, if you want, it's optional, is put your little finger also on the fifth fret on the D string here. Okay, and we're just going to hit that once. And then we're going to move that shape down to the first fret. So we go G, F. So here we go, this is the change. And we change to first fret on the E string and ring finger on the third fret on the A string. Once again, you can bring this pinky if you want to. And we just do those for short strums. So it's like 3, 4, 1. Then we get started on the rhythm. So on this hand, it's just all very quick. Okay, and I'm using a pick for this particular trip, for this song. And then I find it easier, because we're going to go to an E minor, I find it easier to then just tuck these fingers together, leave this finger on this string and just move it down to the second fret and tuck the finger underneath. Once again, that's called finger economy. So if we had to do that, that's a lot of movement. So if we go from this, sorry, to that, that's a lot easier. So then we're on an E minor, so A string second fret and D string second fret also. And then we can start that rhythm. Really simple. It's 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and every chord that I tell you, we're doing that pattern. We're doing it for two bars or two rhythms. I can't talk today. 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, 2, and 3, and 4. Okay. So that's your rhythm. Down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, up. Okay. So this is your beginning. Down, 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 up, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, up. We're then changing to a G chord. Now, in the video that you saw at the beginning, I was changing between this style of G and that style of G. To be honest, it doesn't really matter, but for this particular G, because I'm in this shape, I'm gonna flip to that, okay? So that's the folk G, so that's first fret on the A, second fret on the A string, third fret on the E string, third finger on the B string on the third fret and pinky on the third fret on the E. So there you go, so you've got E minor, 3 and 4, and this is just over that solo. And then that's the same with the singing. So you will be doing 4 G's leading from the solo into the singing, okay? So you're holding it for double the amount of time. As G was going over, E minor. This time with E minor, I go to middle fingers, okay? As mountains, C, I saw. So C from it, that style E minor, it's the quickest way of doing it rather than using these fingers. Is index on the first fret on the B string, middle on the second fret on the D, and ring on the third fret on the G. See, then to G. And then that time, so I don't mean to confuse you, but that time when I go to a G, it's just quicker and easier to move these fingers up and pinky down. Doesn't matter that you don't have this note holding down here on the third fret on the B. And that's the G that I do next. We stay on G again through another verse.
pistol.
E minor.
Then produce my rapier.
C. So D, index on the first, on the D string, on the first, sorry, the G string, I'll get it right in a minute, on the G string on the second fret, middle finger on the second fret on the E, and ring finger on the third fret on the B. Strum the bottom four strings for that chord. D, C, so that time you do C four times, so it's... G. Whiskey in the jar. And then that goes back to our power chord. So that time though, instead of going, I just hit the bass note of the G, lead to F power chord, then to our E minor, however you want to do it, okay? So let's just do that chorus again. So we've got D. So there you have it. I'll just take you through the strings you need to be strumming. For the open chord, so for the G you strum all six, for the E minor all six, for the D bottom four, for the C bottom five, and that's all the chords. Well, the two power chords at the beginning, you just hit the top two strings, or three strings if you've got the pinky down, okay? Good, so if you'd like to learn the dun, 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 that little solo part, then all you need to do is go to my website, which is learnguitarinlondon.com. I've put a link down here right now, and sign up to the student area, all completely free, just takes an email address. By the way, on the website, there's tons more lessons like this. I think we're getting over 100 now on there, which is fantastic. All taught in this way. So yeah, if you click that link, just need to pop in your email address. That'll put you on my mailing list. I just send out guitar hints and tips to help you learn better guitar. That's, I think, all you need to know. Cheers. Take care. See you soon. Bye.